love me, you will obey what I command. If you love me, you will obey what I command. Hallelujah. Gusa jirani yako mwambie obedience.
Obedience.
Mwambie kutii.
Kutii.
If you love God, you are going to obey His word. Kama unampenda Bwana, utatii neno lake. Also, in verse 19, sorry, verse 21, chapter 14 of John, verse number 21, I think, yeah. Whoever has my commands and obey them, whoever has what? Whoever has my command and he obeys them. Hallelujah. He is the one who loves me. And he who loves me will be loved by my Father, and I too will love him and show myself to him. Amen. So, if you have the commandment of God, yes, you have the commandment of God. That is not enough. You have the commandment and you keep them. You obey them. Then, you love God. That is a sign even to God himself that you love him. And the Bible says that, and my Father will love him. Hallelujah.
Amen.
My Father will love him. So it begins with you. Amen. Inaanza na nani? Mwambie jirani yako inaanza na wewe. Yes, it begins with you. If you love him by obeying his word, by keeping his commands, then he will also show his love to you. And Jesus says, I too will show my love to you. Hallelujah. So keeping the word of God draws the love of God upon your life. Keeping the word of God involves God in all your matters. Hallelujah. The more you love God, the more God is involved in your life. Remember, we are talking about foundation. So the more you love him, the more you keep his word, the more he strengthens your foundation. The more he makes your foundation a strong foundation for your life. Hallelujah. Also, in the book of Jeremiah chapter 7. Jeremiah chapter 7 verse 23. The Bible says, please stop making noise, please. But I gave them this command. Obey me, and I will be your God, and you will be my people. Hallelujah.
Amen.
I gave them this command. God is saying, obey me, and I will be your God. So if you disobey God, he refuses from being your God. If you obey God, he accepts being your God. Amen.
Amen.
Obey me and I will be your God. And you will be my people. So if you don't obey God, you become the people for who? That's not your portion. Guza jirani yako mwambie hiyo si sehemu yako.
Hiyo si sehemu yako.
Mwambie wewe unatii Mungu.
Amen.
And so because you obey God, you become the people of God.
Amen.
By obeying God, you become the people of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the Bible says that walk in all the ways I command you, that it may go well with you. Walk in the all way, in all ways that I command you, that it may be well with you. So if you walk otherwise, it becomes otherwise, isn't it? So walk in the ways of God. Walk in the orders of God, and it shall be well with you. It shall be well with you when you walk in the ways of God. When you walk in the orders of God, it shall be well with you. Amen.
Amen.
The Bible says that obedience is better than sacrifice. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 15 from verse 22 to 24. Obedience is better than sacrifice. Obedience is better than the fat of a lamb. That is what the word of God says. Amen.
Amen.
So you can be saved. It's a sacrifice to be saved. You give your life to God. Giving your life is a sacrifice. Amen.
Amen.
But if you are born again and you don't obey, then the Bible says that obedience is better than sacrifice. Hallelujah.
Amen.
God considers obedience. Amen.
Amen.
To bless you, because when you obey, it means that you are walking in His directions. You are walking in His ways. You are walking in His orders. So, your foundation must be set. Your foundation must be established in the Word of God. Hallelujah. You are supposed to give your life, to surrender your life. Everything that you do, you surrender to God. Whatever that you do, you surrender to God. In your education, you surrender to God. Every morning you wake up and you pray, God, give me grace to get everything that belongs to me today when I go into a classroom. Amen.
Amen.
Surrendering to God and obeying God will make you to have a strong foundation that is going to give you a better life in your future. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ni wangapi wamebarikiwa hata mkifunga saa hii? Ni wangapi wanasema niendelee? Ni wangapi wanasema nifike hapo? Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yeah. So we are talking about foundation. And your foundation cannot be strong if it is not based in the word of God. Your foundation can only be strong, and your house will be eternal if it is built on the foundation of God. The foundation of God is the foundation by the word of God. The foundation of obedience. Obedience to God. Amen.
Amen.
Even when you read the book of Ephesians talking about the family, this one, yeah, I'm going to say it to you. Husbands are requested to love their wives. Wives are requested to submit. But the children are requested to do what?
Obey.
To obey their parents. And if they obey, they will have a long life. Amen.
Amen.
So, obedience, how much you obey determines how much long you will live. Amen.
Amen.
So there is something about obedience. And I'm just praying, God, that this thing is going to get into your system. I'm not just preaching to you. I want you to get what I'm saying. Because I know that one day in your life, you will remember this day that a preacher came and preached about obedience. And from that day, because I obeyed, something that is happening in my life is a good thing. Ilibadilisha maisha yangu kutoka hiyo siku. hiyo ndio maombi yangu. Amen. I don't just want to fulfill a program of a rally ya kwamba nilikuja nikahubiri, but I want that it is my prayer to God ya kwamba kuna Mungu ambaye atabadilishwa na hili neno. Kuna Mungu ambaye alikuwa ameindua destiny yake na shetani kupitia disobedience, ambaye atakuwa na strong your destiny that the devil was trying to take away by giving you the spirit of disobedience. God is restoring it by giving you a fresh spirit from heaven, the spirit of obedience. Amen.
Amen.
You see, many are times when we like ourselves. Yeah. You are making yourself, you are this, and you know from your inside I'm not this. You are not supposed to pretend. You are supposed to stand in the truth and do what is right. Amen.
Amen.
And so the source that you are going to get are going to bring glory to God and are going to make you a better person.
Inua mkono wako sema Bwana Yesu.
Bwana Yesu.
Sema kwa sauti Bwana Yesu.
Bwana Yesu.
Siku ya leo.
Siku ya leo.
Ninaomba roho ya kutotii. Kwa sauti ninaomba roho ya kutotii. Isiwe sehemu yangu.
Isipate nafasi katika maisha yangu.
Bwana Yesu. Naomba jioni ya leo. Unimiminie.
Roho ya utiifu.
Ndani ya neno lako.
I'm going to put a word before I mess up.
Amen. I say whatever that you have not been able to do from today. From today, God has restored it to your life. Mungu amekurejeshea. The dreams that you have already killed, from today they are restored. Hallelujah. Wengine wanasema nitakuwa lawyer. Na katika on the way, akabadilisha nia akasema, hii na hii imenishinda. So it's like I don't know. I want to speak to you. Please listen to me. Listen to what I'm saying. Amen. Listen to the message. Don't listen to the language. I'm saying this. Whatever that you have given up on tomorrow. Amen. Kesho amka ukiwa na mipangilio yake. Chochote ambacho uliabort. Chochote ambacho ulitupilia mbali. Nasema ya kwamba kesho amka ukiwa na mipango yake, kwa maana Bwana jioni ya leo amekurejeshea kwa sababu ya kutii neno lake. Hallelujah. And now, I don't feel to preach anymore. I just want to pray with some people. Amen. And we are going to pray. Hallelujah. Listen to me carefully. There is no way that God can operate in anything other than his table. Amen. God has given us the altar. The altar is a place of spiritual transaction. Your bodies are the table of the Holy Spirit. Mwili wako ni hekalu ya Roho Mtakatifu. Hallelujah. Na mwili ambao si hekalu ya Roho Mtakatifu, Roho Mtakatifu ana makao pale na ana kazi ya kufanya pale. Amen. So God cannot do anything in your life. Whatever you have heard from the word of God, God cannot do it if you have not dedicated your body as a temple of God. In Isaiah chapter 46, the Bible says, Mungu anasema ya kwamba, the heaven is my throne and the earth is my footstool. Where have you made a house for me? Ya kwamba mbingu ni mahali pake pa kukalia, na hapa duniani mahali pake ambapo amewekelea miguu yake. Je, wewe umemjengea Mungu nyumba yake wapi? Amen. The house of God is your body. Your body is the temple of God. And God wants your body